folks, and welcome back to my little shed. It's been a while. Yeah, although I love being out here, it's very difficult for me to get much time in the shed at the moment. And also, I would like to thank all those in the woodworking community that have sent me get well wishes for my wife. I really appreciate that. Thank you very much. What I'd like to do this week is to have a go at some wood staining. It's something I've never done before, so I thought, well, let's give it a little go. I've done some research on YouTube on the woodturning communities, and I've had a look at a few channels. Sam from the Wyoming Woodturner, and Martin Savian Smith. They're both excellent, but I thought I'd like to have a go at something a bit smaller for my first time. I've decided to make some flowers and stain them up. I'm going to make two sets of flowers. One set I'm going to make and I'm going to stain, and the other set I'm going to make and I'm going to leave in natural wood. I do like natural wood, I must admit. The set that I'm going to stain is made from an old pallet. It's hardwood, I don't know what kind of wood. It's like a white wood, but it is hardwood, quite heavy. It's not the best wood, but for an experiment of my first time, that will do. What I want to do is, I'll take you through the process of making the flowers. There's many ways of making these flowers. There's great channels out there for tuition if you want to look. Carl Jacobson makes the flowers. Alan Stratton makes the flowers. Richard Ford, Larry in the little tiny trailer workshop, he makes them. There's lots of information on making them. So I'm going to make them anyway today, and I'm going to use the Richard Ford method, the one I see. I don't know whether it's his method, it's the one I seen him doing, so I'm going to use that method. I'll take you through that and then we'll come back a little bit later. So, this is my blank. It's a piece of pallet wood, it's not good wood at all, but I'm experimenting doing it. I've never done this before, so I don't want to waste good wood. So this at the moment is 2 inches in diameter, and it's 4 inches in length. I'm going to end up using about 3 inches, maybe 2¾ along here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a bowl gouge. Sorry, yeah, a small 3/8 gouge, and just put a rough shape and keep the tailstock in as long as I can. So we'll do that first. So you see, what I'm trying to do is bring it into a shape of the flower. I don't want to go too far because I've got to drill it out and everything yet, and then leave myself some thickness for, you know, doing the final shape. Right, so I've got a rough shape there. And what I shall do now is I'll get the drill set up and I'll drill the centre out. I won't go too mad because I'll use the hollowing tool to finish it off. Well, let me get set up for that. Okay, now I'm just going to drill out the centre of the flower. Slow this down. Everything's locked. And the thing with this is just take your time. It's no sense in going too fast, it just ruins the bits. So, there's where I'm up to, right at the very back. Now I haven't taken a lot off, but I've taken enough to get a small hollowing tool in and to leave me some room to shape both the inside and the outside. So that's the next step, 5/16 hollowing tool. So I'm just going to go in there and gently take the sides and thin the sides out a bit. I'll probably work from both sides. I'll do a bit on the inside and then shape the outside a bit more. I'll just go from side to side. Okay. Well, that's doing a lovely job. Oh, it is doing a lovely job. Excellent. So I'll keep on doing this till I've got it nice and thin. I think I'll just shape the outside up a bit more now before I lose too much meat. That's nice and thin, it's nice and equal all the way back, and I'm actually right up to here, so it's going to be nice and light. The next step, bit of sanding and then start marking it up for cutting the flower petals. Ready now for putting the marks on for cutting the petals. So what I've done is I've made a story stick, and this story stick will go in and I'll just mark it off. The idea of it is the story stick just goes in and lines up where you're going to, so each of the lines line up with the cut. I made a batch of these, that's why it's quicker just to make a story stick. So what we do is we put the story stick in, and we take a pencil and we just mark out for the petals. Okay, so there's our marks. Now the next thing I have to do is, you see the petals where they go straight and where they bend, so I normally put two marks there for that. So where I'm going to curve the petals, I'm going to go, I just do it by eye, I don't measure it. I'm going to go to there, and the petals are going to come down on a straight cut to there. So there's our first two marks. Now all we do is we get the pencil, and each of these marks, using the tool rest, we just come down in a straight line. And this will give us our five petals. So there's our marks. The next stage, just lean on the tool rest, is in between these lines that I drew. I just put a little dot. I just do it by eye, guess the centre. As I say, it hasn't got to be perfect. All I do now is I just simply draw around from this to there, which forms the petal. I just curve it round. And it doesn't matter if your curves are not great or perfect, because when you come to do the sanding, then you can finalize your petals. So I think you've got the idea now. What we do is, this is waste in between, we cut these out. Now this one is not bad, but if you get any blemishes towards the end or anything, you can always make your petal so it's, the blemish becomes in a waste spot. I just forgot that one. That's all waste. So the next thing is to simply cut them out. So you can use anything. On some of the other flowers I've done, I used my small dovetail saw. I've even used my tenon saw. But on this particular one, I'm going to try the little junior axe saw. So basically, all I'm going to do is folly this round. On the straight part is just run my saw through and take it down the cut to the next line, and that will form the petal through the flowers, the five petals. So we'll just carry on and do that until it's finished. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to run my tenon saw through, because the blade's a bit wider, just to widen that curve. This just allows me to get the sandpaper in a bit better. There we go. So the next job now, of course, is sanding. Now, as I say, I seen a lad in Australia doing this about a year or so ago. I will give you his name and leave a link later on. I'm not trying to say that it's my sort of idea or creation, it belongs to someone else, so I will give them credit for it. I'm going to start sanding up now. I know you'd love to sit and watch me sanding, but I'm not going to let you, so I'll come back when I've sanded it up a little bit. This is the last one that I'm doing in this batch. Can you see that okay? Now, this piece of wood at the back is a piece of the pallet wood that I took the blanks from. So a few days ago I made the 4-inch blanks. Where am I? The 4-inch blanks. And I got them to 4 inches long and 2 inches in diameter. And today I've just done my half a dozen tulips, or whatever the, you know, whatever you think they are. So they're all slightly different, but they're all the same. Now my next stage is to take them to the bench and just refine them all. Do a bit of refining with a little Dremel tool. I'll sit at the bench and I'll spend an hour just with the little tool, getting them all into the shape that I want, giving them a bit of refinement. And then each one I'll put back onto the lathe. I'll drill the hole through the centre, 1/4-inch hole for the 1/4-inch dowel. And I'll give them a good sanding up. And then stain them. So it's the first time I've ever used stains. So we'll just have to see how it goes. Well, that's the project completed. The coloured flowers didn't come out too bad, actually. I used the chestnut spirit stain to colour them, and I finished them off with a spray lacquer. I need to make a vase. I haven't got a vase yet to I haven't got a piece of wood good enough to make a coloured vase yet. And again, the natural wood ones, the spalted beech and American white oak, and as you can see, they've came out quite nice. They're just polished up and done again with a spray lacquer. So the project hasn't come out too bad, really, for my first attempt with the colours. I'll just turn this camera around. As I say, all the channels that I mentioned while making this video, I'll put links up below, so you can go to them channels and check them out. The staining, yes, it's definitely different. It's something that does take a little bit of practice, but you can get some very nice results. I'll need to make the vase, and when I do, I'll make a video and show you that when it's completed. So I'll put some stills up at the end. So that's about it for me. Till next time. Thank you to all my subscribers, and thank you all for watching. I'll see you all soon. Don't forget, work safe. Bye for now.